Hello everybody, today we are going to see the solutions of worksheet number 11. Okay, already worksheet is given. So from that, first question is, in the figure ABCD is a quadrilateral in which AB is equal to BC and AD is equal to CD. It is kite shaped figure. Figure is given here. Prove that triangle ABD congruent triangle CBD, and so DB is the bisector and bisector of angle ADC, and BD is the bisector of angle ABC. Okay, and second question is, triangle AOD congruent triangle COD, so that angle AOD is equal to angle COD is equal to one right angle. Okay, once again see, figure is given. In the figure ABCD is a quadrilateral. ABCD is a quadrilateral which is kite shaped. Okay, so AB is equal to BC. Here it is given AB is equal to BC and AD is equal to CD. Sides are same. Then prove that triangle ABD. We have to prove triangle ABD and triangle CBD. CBD are congruent. So DB is the bisector of angle ABC and angle ADC. Okay, so first we will think about first question which they are asking. Okay, so here triangle ABD and triangle CBD. So we will think about triangle ABD and triangle CBD. So here first, in triangle ABD and triangle CBD, okay, ABD and CBD, AB is equal to BC, which is given. Then AD is equal to CD, that is also given, and BD is the common side for both the triangles. So by side, by SSS criteria, we can say both the triangles are congruent. Okay, so now here AB is equal to BC. We are thinking about triangle ABD and triangle CBD. So AB is equal to BC, AB is equal to CB. Reason is given. Okay, it is given. Then second thing, AD is equal to CD. AD is equal to CD. This is also given. And BD is the common side for both the triangles. So BD is equal to BD. BD is equal to BD. So this is common side for both the triangles. So side, by SSS criteria, both the triangles are congruent. So here we can say triangle ABD congruent triangle CBD by side. Okay, now both the triangles are congruent. Now here we have to prove that DB is the bisector of angle ADC. DB, this is the diagonal. DB is the bisector of angle ABC and angle ADC. Okay, so now we have given proof this and this triangle is congruent. Okay, so now we can say ABD is equal to CBD. Angle ABD means this angle is equal to this, as well as we can say angle ADB is equal to angle CDB. Which reason we can give here? By cyclicity, because already we have given proof both the triangles are congruent. So now we can write here angle ABD is equal to angle CBD. This is, I am saying here, first one. And second thing, angle ADB and is equal to angle CDB. Angle ADB is equal to angle CDB. Okay, this is, I am saying, second one. Okay, here we need to write reason. So reason is by CPCT, corresponding parts of congruent triangle. By CPCT, these two angles are equal. Okay, we are going to use this for next. So here see, if angles are equal, this and this angle is equal, that means BD is the bisector of angle B. Here this and this angle is equal, so here also BD or DB is the bisector of angle D. Angle D means what? Angle ADC. So here we can write, which they are asking, DB is the bisector of angle ADC and BD is the bisector of angle ABC. So here we can write finally, hence DB is the bisector, DB is the bisector of angle ADC and BD is the bisector of angle ABC. Okay, so here we got proof of first question. Okay, proof of this first one. Now we will think about second one. Okay, so in second question they are asking triangle AOD and COD. Okay, so see here triangle AOD and triangle COD. Okay, we have to prove both the triangles are congruent. So here I am taking that in triangle AOD and triangle COD. COD. Triangle AOD and triangle COD. First we will think how to prove both the triangles are congruent. Okay, so see here. Here it is not given AO is equal to OC. Okay, but what is given? AD is equal to CD. AD is equal to CD. Second thing, OD is common side. This OD is common side for both the triangles, for this and for this. So two things we have. As well as we can say here angle ADO is equal to angle CDO, because here we have given ADB. ADB means what? ADB we can write ADO. Okay, and CDB we can write CDO, because here angle is important. Okay, so by side angle side we can say both the triangles are congruent. Okay, so first we need to prove both the triangles are congruent. So see here AD is equal to CD. What is the reason? Given. This is given. Okay, then second thing, ADO angle, ADO is equal to angle CDO. Angle CDO. Reason we need to write, here we can write from second. Okay, from second we can write here. From 2. Okay, and third thing, OD. OD is the common side for both the triangles. So OD is equal to OD, which is common side for both the triangles. Okay, so now we can say side angle side by SAS, both the triangles are congruent. So here I am saying triangle AOD congruent triangle COD by side angle side by SAS criteria. This criteria is important. Okay, if you will give this all the things and finally you will not write here criteria, then you will not get their marks. Okay, so here criteria is important. So now here we have given proof both the triangles are congruent. One more thing they are asking, see, if triangles are congruent, so that AOD is equal to COD is equal to one right angle. One right angle means 90 degree. AOD means this angle. This and this angle we have to show a right angle, means 90 degree. Okay. Now see here, both the triangles are congruent. Both the triangles are congruent. So we can say AOD is equal to COD. Angle AOD is equal to angle COD. Okay. Which reason we can give here? Triangles are congruent. So these are the corresponding angles. So here we can write reason by CPCT, corresponding parts of congruent triangle. Okay, so now these two angles are equal. Also, they are forming linear pair, means AOD plus COD is equal to 180 degree, because these two angles are forming linear pair. So here we can write angle AOD plus angle COD is equal to 180 degree, because they are forming linear pair. Okay, so sum of these two angles is 180 degree, but these two angles are same. Two angles are same. By CPCT we said here both the angles are equal. So we can write COD we can replace by AOD, or AOD we can replace by COD. So here I am taking angle AOD plus angle AOD is equal to 180 degree, because both the angles are same. So now if you will do here addition, we can write here 2 times angle AOD is equal to 180 degree. So angle AOD is equal to 180 divided by 2 is 90 degree. Okay, which they are asking us. AOD is 90 degree, and AOD and COD, angle COD is also 90 degree. Okay, So these are the two proofs of these two questions, and this question is from NCERT book. So see carefully and solve in your notebook. Okay, so our second problem is, if diagonal AC of a parallelogram ABCD bisects angle A, show that, two questions are there, first one, it bisects angle C also, and second question, ABCD is a rhombus. Okay, two questions they are asking. Once again, see, if diagonal AC of a parallelogram ABCD bisects angle A, okay, this is given. Quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram. Okay, so here given, in given things, ABCD is a parallelogram. ABCD is a parallelogram. Okay, in that, what is given? Bisects angle A. Okay, diagonal AC bisects angle A. AC bisects angle A means what? Angle 1 is equal to angle 2. This is given. Okay. Now here we have to prove it bisects angle C also. First one, it AC bisects angle C also. And second, ABCD is a rhombus. ABCD is a rhombus. Okay, so these two things we need to show. Okay, so now in proof, this is very simple proof. Okay, so see here, ABCD is a parallelogram. ABCD is a parallelogram. Okay, so here we need to mention ABCD is a parallelogram, which is given. They have told us parallelogram. So opposite sides of parallelogram are always parallel and equal. So AB is parallel to DC. AB and DC are parallel. That time AC is a transversal. It intersects at point A and C. Okay, so we can say angle 3 is equal to angle 1. So for angle 1 is equal to angle 3. Okay, why? Alternate angles. Angle 1 is equal to angle 3. Okay, again AD is parallel to BC. AD and BC are parallel to each other. Okay, and AC is a transversal. So in that time, angle 2 is equal to angle 4. Okay, the same reason, alternate angles. So here I am saying this is one, and this is, I am saying, second one. Okay, and what is given? Angle 1 is equal to angle 3. Angle 2 is equal to angle 4. But it is given that angle 1 is equal to angle 2. It is given. Angle 1 and angle 2 are equal. That is given. Okay. So, this is, I am saying, third one. This is, we will say, third one. Okay. So, angle 1 is equal to angle 3. Angle 2 is equal to angle 4. So, but it is given that angle 1 and angle 2 are equal. So, we can say angle 3 and angle 4 are equal. From 1 and 1, 2 and 3. For first, second and third, we can say angle 3 is equal to angle 4. So, here we can give reason from first, second and third. We can say angle 3 and angle 4 are equal. Angle 3 and 4 are equal means what? AC bisects angle C also. Okay, so here we can say, so AC bisects angle C also, which they are asking. This is the answer of first question. Okay, it bisects angle C also. Now we will think about ABCD. Second question, ABCD is a rhombus. Now here we have to prove ABCD is a rhombus. Okay, now as we know that this is a parallelogram, so we can say angle A is equal to angle C, because this is a parallelogram. So angle A is equal to angle C. Okay, so half of angle A, suppose I will take half of angle A, then we can say half of angle C also, that is also equal. If A and C are equal, then half of A is equal to half of C. Okay, so half of angle A, these are AC is the bisector of angle A and angle C also. So half of angle A, I can write angle 2 is equal to half of angle C, we can take angle 3 is equal to angle 3. We can take any angle 1 and angle 4 also we can take. Okay, here I have taken 2 and 3 on the same side of transversal we have taken. If angle 2 and 3 are equal, angle 2 and 3 are equal, then sides opposite of angles, equal angles are always same. So we can say AD is equal to BC. AD is equal to DC. Okay, so AD is equal to CD. Okay, sides here reason sides opposite of equal angles are same. Okay, AD and DC are equal. Similarly we can show AB is equal to CD. AB is equal to CB. AB and CB are equal. Okay, means AD is equal to CD, AB is equal to CB, means all the four sides are equal in length. So we can say AD is equal to DC is equal to CB is equal to AB. Okay, all the sides are equal in length, means quadrilateral ABCD is a rhombus. Quadrilateral ABCD is a rhombus, because that is the one of the property of rhombus. Okay, thank you.